Today we are going to speak about Token Flex, Autodesk Token Flex licensing. My name is Oren. With us we have Veronica, our marketing leader, and Branislav that leads our technical support. So let's just dive into the Autodesk token licensing. So Branislav, can you give us a few words about the token licensing?
Yes, of course. So the Autodesk token Flex licensing system is a very specific system provided by Autodesk, specifically tailored to some of their biggest customers. It's usually the corporations where you can expect that they are using basically the whole Autodesk product portfolio, and they are not just tied to that one. You all know AutoCAD, that's the main Autodesk applications, but Autodesk is much more than that. And for these big companies, when they use the whole portfolio and they have many, many, many users, it's not really beneficial for them to go for the either the named user licensing, and even the standard network perpetual model is not the best, like Autodesk did use in the past with the serializer keys, because the token Flex, as by the way is in the name, gives you two things: tokens and flexibility.
Yes.
And the flexibility is something that is very important. So
okay.
Oren,
do you
want to tell us how it works on the technical level? How does the token Flex actually
work? Definitely. But before we go on, so what you explain is that the target audience is the big customer. So yes. Also the targets the named licensing, the new cloud named licensing to the small and medium businesses. The token licensing is for the big customers. So if we look on the overall strategy, we have to right now, as they decided to discontinue the network licenses, we have a token Flex for the big customers and named licensing for the others. Correct?
Yes, that's correct. I think that is the general idea where they want to actually go in the future.
Yes, and okay, so talking about the technical implementation is, but Autodesk just continued to use the same FlexLM, so you actually get the same license manager that was used for networking licensing. And the change is that you are getting an unlimited license file, which is it's the dream of any CAD manager worldwide. So I can use anything as much as I want. And actually the usage is accumulated within the log files. These log files are sent to Autodesk for analysis. And the policy is that Autodesk is charging for a set number of tokens for each type of product. So it might be 20 tokens for Autodesk for 24 hours. So it's always number of tokens for a time unit of use, and if you continue to use it, you pay again. Now when I say type of license, is like families of products, so Autodesk just group specific number of products to a family, and all these family is paying the set price for that family. So that's the implementation. So let's again repeat why. So Branislav, why would I, as a quite big customer of Autodesk, prefer the Token Flex over a network license if they allow me to continue it? And why would I prefer it over a subscription license?
Well, the reason is extremely simple, because if you imagine a big corporation, even though the corporation may use all of the Autodesk portfolio and they do provide different products, like I said, it's not just about the AutoCAD, it's very likely that Autodesk products are not the only CAD products that are implemented in the company, because these bigger corporations, they work on multiple designing projects at the same time, and it's highly likely that maybe not everything actually can be covered by the Autodesk product portfolio. So it's not like when in a small business you have your dedicated AutoCAD designer, and you can pretty well estimate that this person is working with the AutoCAD on a daily basis. Maybe he's not utilizing it for those 8 or 10 hours that he's sitting at the office, but he is working primarily with the product. However, on the other hand, in the big corporation, an engineer may use wide variety of the products. It's maybe he's using AutoCAD for something, and he's using Inventor for something else, and then he also uses CATIA. So it's harder to actually say, okay, now I have 5,000 CAD users and I need to buy 5,000 AutoCAD subscriptions, because that is A, extremely expensive, it's really not flexible. So the Token Flex program comes into place, and it gives you the flexibility to actually make sure that even if I have a user who needs the AutoCAD just to do a very specific thing, maybe once a week, or maybe he only needs to use AutoCAD once a year, or even once per contract period, I can still very safely accommodate his request without having to worry to buy the product completely and without having to purchase an extra subscription. I can accommodate it fairly well. And I think this is one of the key advantages why the Token Flex will remain the option for Autodesk's enterprise customers.
Yeah, and actually, this is very interesting, because we need to remember that token licensing existing before. One very good example is the IBM Rational products that were always licensed using tokens. So you never needed to decide specifically, I want to buy this feature. So you just buy tokens, and you can use these token according to a rate for each product. You can just consume anything you want. So the customer investment is in the vendor and not in the specific feature, because the needs change and the project requirement change, and my focus within the company is changing. So this is why we think that the best licensing for the customer is the token licensing, and we chose this also, this licensing for OpenLM, and we are currently implementing it, and we already did for the agent functionality, and we are slowly implementing that for the OpenLM as a whole. Next question is, what are the challenges that we have when we are managing this type of licensing? So basically, I don't want to, we can't go into the full details of the implementation, which is complex, in this discussion, but you can have multiple license servers within your organization, and this is creating problems because of the consuming time zone, consumption time zone, and the time zone of the server. So you might get into a situation where a user is starting his Autodesk is at 8 in the morning, goes home 5 o'clock in the evening, and actually paying twice for the product, because the switch was happening in the license server time zone. So this is something we explain in the other video that we have. And the other is inherited into the networking, network licensing technologies, that people tend to leave the product idle and go. And then, okay, that person that left the office 5 o'clock in the evening, at midnight, he will consume another license, and he might not come at all, or might not use Autodesk to, the day after, but still he will consume the tokens of the next day. And the same for weekends and so on. So definitely there is a lot. If we do a better management, we can definitely be more efficient using the tokens. Something we must mention is that Autodesk require their customers to decide on the number of tokens in the beginning of the year. And if there are tokens that were not used, the official policy is that, okay, you can't use it. It's disappearing. I heard that they sometimes forgive their customer, but I'm not sure about it. And if you need more tokens, of course you can get them, but you will pay probably a much higher rate for these tokens. So, Branislav, how can OpenLM help our customers to manage their token licensing?
So just to elaborate a little bit on the contract. Yes, it's true. You know, it's either a 1 year or single year contract, or it can be a multi-year contract. And they do actually offer you something. And like you said, usually official policy of Scott that the unused tokens are discarded. And you know what goes into the renegotiation of the next contractual terms that remains behind closed doors. They do offer something specific on top of that you can actually get if you go into a multi-year contract. And you can get tokens for 1 year, second year, third year, plus you can get a certain amount of, they call it multi-year contract tokens. So it happens, but when you actually use up all your tokens for that particular year, you start pulling from that multi-year, which is like an extra pool on top. But it only happens in the multi-year contracts. But you asked where OpenLM comes in and how can we assist? Well, OpenLM at best assist as we do with other license, other engineering applications and other products, and that is when the time of the renewal comes. Because, like you correctly said, you need to decide on the amount of tokens beforehand. And Autodesk they do have their own reporting system, which you can find on the webpage. If you have the Token Flex contract, you can see how much tokens are consuming, and you can actually do an extraction to a CSV file to see how you have been doing, but. As you, Oren, correctly said, there are situations where it can happen that the user is actually duplicating the token usage, which is one of the key functionalities that OpenLM has within their Token Flex implementation, where it can help you identify these users, like you said, because of the time zone. Not every big customer actually has the luxury of implementing 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 license servers. Some of them do. So it actually, what you said, doesn't happen. And, you know, each region actually has their own specific license server, but some of them don't do that. And you can end up with a duplicate token usage. Also, another key functionality for the license manager that is looking at the Autodesk product portfolio is seeing if the users are actually behaving, because user discipline is key when it comes to any licensing model requires user discipline, but the networking license model requires better user discipline to actually be more efficient. And this is where OpenLM can assist you. What I meant by actually overseeing the products, that you see that if somebody is working with one of the more expensive Autodesk products, that, you know, and sometimes the token consumption can be 10 times more for their more sophisticated products compared to something like an AutoCAD LT. But I see that at the same time, the user is also running that AutoCAD LT. Well, then he is again wasting tokens that, you know, could be utilized for somebody else. And last but not least, as you correctly said, and we know this has been a prevalent case for OpenLM's customers and other, basically everybody who is utilizing the network licensing model, again, it comes to the user discipline of actually when I'm done with my work, I close the program and, you know, I shut down my laptop. Not many users do. And OpenLM, again, with our agent extension, can actually come in, monitor the idle time. We can even close the sessions. But the key variable is the monitoring the idle time, because you can see whether the people are actually working while they are consuming the licenses. And all these three things, when put together, are crucial to the license manager to actually be able to see and make the token usage more efficient. And then when the time for a negotiation of the contract comes, maybe, you know, you will be able to get 100,000 token less for the next licensing period and save a lot of money.
Exactly. Thank you. So to summarize, OpenLM is helping in any aspect of the management of the tokens, like saving on time zone switching and doing the planning of the locations of the license manager, help you in the audit because you have your own number and you can see how it compares to the numbers that Autodesk brings. You can, of course, and that's a main problem, to close idle sessions in time before they consume additional tokens, and especially prepare you with a very good prediction on the numbers of tokens that you need to discuss on with Autodesk for the next years. Thank you for the discussion. Anything you would like to add before we say goodbye?
Oh, I think we are good to go. What I would like to add, and we would like to see more our customers actually go ahead and utilizing the Token Flex solution. I can understand, again, from the perspective of the license manager, that sometimes it's hard to actually make sure that you take care of the complete license portfolio that is under your hands, or you are maybe just content in checking the Autodesk webpage and seeing, okay, this is how many I used. Let's go with the same quantity for next year. If you actually are the type that wants to dive deeper, or your budget is, you know, being more restricted, or you just really, really want to optimize, try the Token Flex feature. Especially, I'm now talking to the customers who already have the feature. Go ahead and use it. It's really amazing.
Maybe one more point we forgot to mention is distributing the cost between cost centers. This is something that if you implement Token Flex solution, you can still do that while you're using this new licensing policy. So it was a pleasure talking with you today. Thank you very much. And I'm looking forward for the next week discussions. Thank you.